condemn the act of violence created by Dato' Saravanan and his gang towards the freedom of press, especially. I feel sympathy to our beloved Mr. Om Tyagarajan and his staff and the legal Madam Saraswati. And we shouldn't condone this kind of a severe, grievous act of violence towards the freedom of the paper, press. And it's become a trend to Dato' Saravanan to use gangsterism to intimidate the freedom of speech. I'm sure Tamil Madhavan have come out without fear and favor, without any, they have come out. If you feel that you are, Dato' Saravanan has been intimidated, as what Mr. Palaniswamy have said, you have all means to use law. As a deputy minister, I feel very shy, ashamed for the prime minister to have such a hooligan man in the cabinet. He should be immediately sacked from the post of deputy minister. And to the MIC, MIC president, I asked him, sir, please act, take a strong disciplinary action before the name of MIC has been tarnished. It's already been tarnished, but I think to save the party, I think the president has to take a swift act without delay, any delay. And I have to apologize. I was not in the country for the past 15 days. I went to Mount Kailash. I only present yesterday night when I heard about this matter that our Dato' Mr. Om Tyagarajan was being attacked by the gangster. I think it's a strongly Malaysian student. We all Malaysians love peace and prosperity. We are not condoning any kind of violent threat intimidating the freedom of the press. So I'm here today to give strong support to Tamil Madhavan, especially the press freedom has to be sustained in this country. We are not going to support anyone, and we are not going to scan, not going to Dato' Saravanan or anybody for the matter that we Indians love peace. We Indians are born for the name of Dharma, love, anbu, pasam, kudaiyavargal number. As an Indian, I feel shy. I feel shy for this kind of act. So, to all these people who has been attacked, I, on behalf of Malaysian Pakistan Party, I feel sorry and I like to throw my strongest support for the press freedom. Nandri Vanakkam.